My goal on this channel is to weed out all the bad cheap video games from the good ones. I want you to be able to turn a $5 bill into hours or days of entertainment on your Nintendo Entertainment System, your Switch. And the best way for you to maximize the value of your money is to avoid spending it on games like Pocket Mini Golf. I was raised with the saying, if you have nothing nice to say, then don't say anything at all. But if I stayed true to that saying, this would be a very short review. So I picked up this game because recently I've been very interested in golf, even started playing for realsies, and I'm not very good. And since the weather is starting to get cold, I need a way to get my golf fixed indoors and practice on my short game during the winter. So for the low price of $1.24, I picked up Pocket Mini Golf. This is where the disappointment began. It opens up to a pastel-y looking menu in different shades of blue and green with touches of red on top of a cloudy blue sky background. There you have it. In one sentence, I accurately described what you'll be looking at for the entire game. The same scene over and over again with slightly different colors on each course. The music accompanies the graphics perfectly. It's the same dull music you might expect if you're going to an Asian buffet with the occasional wind instrument thrown in there to ease you into a relaxing nap. Every once in a while, they jazz it up with some percussion just long enough to get the blood pumping and just as quickly gets back to the boring slow tunes of an open casket funeral. They should have just kept the more upbeat tunes throughout the whole game. I feel like it would make the overall experience just a bit more enjoyable. Okay, so I've set the stage. So far, this game has nothing to appeal to your eyes or your ears. But surely the gameplay can't be ruined. How can you possibly butcher the gameplay of a mini putt video game? Here's how. The goal of each level is to get the ball in the hole. So far, so good. Now you would expect to get rewarded for getting the ball in the hole in as few amount of strokes possible. Wrong! They couldn't give a shit about how many strokes it takes you. You just have to get it in 3 or less strokes or you lose. A hole in one means nothing to this game. If you hit the ball 3 times and don't get it in the hole, it's basically all over. It doesn't even let you retry the level. You either restart the entire game or pay gems to skip the level. This is where the game really falls apart. The whole goal of the game is to beat as many levels as you can, but it's not like Candy Crush where each level is unique and fun. Nope. Every level in this game is boring and repetitive. So repetitive, in fact, that after about 30 levels or so, they start repeating themselves. Every few levels is one of these dumb, easy gem spiral levels that are only in the game to give you a boost of gems so you can keep the game going if you lose and want to continue torturing yourself. Why even make these levels? Why not just put more gems in the regular levels? Or better yet, get rid of the dumb gem system altogether and let people just retry if they lose. Because assuming they have friends lame enough to play this game, you can't brag about your highest level anyways. Because you can just keep grinding this game over and over again until you have enough gems to continue your level progression. And nobody should want to brag about grinding this game. Instead of the way they have it now, they should just have a finite number of unique holes and have the challenge be, who can get to the end in the least amount of strokes? Just like Mini Putt is meant to be played. If it ain't broke, don't break it. I should also mention, the multiplayer is trash as well. Not much is different than the main game. It's either first to finish all the courses wins, or whomever gets the furthest wins. And to put the cherry on the cake, you annoyingly have to reassign the controllers every time you start a versus match.
Now I know what you're thinking. Quiz, you're being way too hard on a game that only costs a buck and a quarter. To that I say, somebody has to, because you could have taken that money and spent it on a game that's awesome, like Conduct Together that I reviewed in the previous episode, and then still had a quarter to go spend on a gumball machine. Anyways, I hope you found the information in this video informative and will avoid this game at all costs. And please hit that like button and subscribe if you want more cheap game reviews like this one. But until next time, keep on questing.